What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome back. We're here for a day in the life because we've actually got the time to do it. So we've got the podcast this morning about 11:30. So we're going to go for breakfast before. I'm going to show you what I eat. Go for the podcast. We're going to go train after, and then just going to round up the day because pretty much is all I do on a Friday. And then I've got a little bit of work, which is me sat down. So you ain't see that part. So without further ado, we'll go for it. Let's show you. So good. Little salt beef bacon. Two bagels. One filled with Nutella and banana. I'm still thinking calories here because I've still got to put on a lot of weight, so I'm excited for this. Yeah. I'm not really. It got me in my true self. Wearing white, eating the Nutella, playing the most dangerous game on the planet. I feel savagery. Sorry, I had to see that.
How are you, Andy?
I'm all good.
I've just been in that bagel place, haven't I?
Good.
Lovely.
Really?
Salt beef bagel. Mm. Not as good as that one on Brick Lane.
It's bagel where you used to go. Truman Brewery.
That's banging, that is. Something specific?
Marketing and branding and business.
Okay. We're going to talk about branding and talk about marketing. In our podcast room, you actually haven't seen the podcast room on the vlog yet, actually. So, yeah, this is the room. You might have actually recognised it off TikTok, other famous places. Not from us, though. Not yet. this is the sofa, these are the mics, this is where we sit, this is where we talk. It's a pretty nice setup, to be honest. You kind of get the lights with it. You can change the RGB lights at the back. And it's a very, very encompassing room. And we rent this space. We come here and it's all ready for us. So it's a perfect service, really. We thoroughly enjoy our time here, which is really good. So I'm not going to tell you where it is, but I'm sure you can find it.
Yeah, preview the last time.
To their time in the industry.
It's probably what we did with Cal, really, right?
Yeah.
That's a big investment into our own coaching.
Absolutely. I went on a lot of education, so the more courses I went on, I found myself in a position whereby people were asking me questions and my ability to answer pretty much all of them. I was like, oh, I'm actually in a position there where I could probably charge a little bit more than I am charging.
I don't know if we need to go into detail. Like, I will do video check-ins on those ones, for example.
Yeah.
I will do a call with them face-to-face every single time, you know, every single month with them. We'll go through your training systematically in detail, you know, so you do get some actual. This is, you offer a price to those people who want to go above and beyond, who are very, very into this and they want to do the best.
Feedback at the start, and someone was telling me, like, you're not doing good enough, and I was like, yeah, I am. It's not the right way to respond to feedback. Yeah. And actually it helped me massively when my ego dropped and I was like, that was actually really good feedback. Mm-hmm. So I would say, yeah, be very receptive to feedback, because at the end of the day, the customer actually is always right. See you later, guys.
Okay, bye. Peace.
Oh, cracking hell. Some sweaty ears.
Yeah, my ears are fucking killing me.
Oh, I'm stiff as a board. So we're in the gym now, straight from the podcast. A little bit of a protein bar, and then straight in for legs. It's a little bit of a different training time than usual. It's at 2 o'clock, so I'm feeling a little bit tired already. I train like 10 a.m, so by 2 o'clock I'm already kind of switched down into work mode. So it's a little bit of a different time, but it's all right. We just try and keep things as similar as possible. We have our pre-workout like normal. We've got our intro like normal. And we're just going to get after legs the best we can. Oh, wow, I'm feeling so weak. Fuck. So I'm coming into week four. No, finishing up my week four, being natty, being on TRT. So we know that with the ester molecules that I'm using, cyprinate and enanthate, it's going to take about 4 to 5 weeks. Anywhere between 4 and 5 weeks for your serum levels of hormone to get back down to normal. So when people come off, and then the week after they come off, they feel, I still feel great. Because you've still got loads of hormone pumping through your system because it's being releasing slowly. So this is where I'm going to start feeling natural. This is where things are going to start feeling heavier. DOMS are going to get a little bit worse, which I've noticed as well. And this is where you've got to persevere, and this is where mentality has to take place. And you've got to fight to keep those weights there and fight to keep that muscle there that you built so hard over that long push season. Oof. Simple little tip on these extensions. This pad here, if you can move it, ideally you want it as high up the knee as possible, just to kind of reduce that shear through the front of the knee. You might have to use a little bit more weight because of it, but trust me, the reduction in knee pressure will be worth it. Chin burner, that is. Oh. Bode well. That feels heavy. Fuck me, man. One more. Stay right here.
One drive, big push. Drive, Josh. Good. Still you? Still. Come on, love that.
Fuck. Oh, God. Thank you. Cafe. I put a little bit extra than a normal scoop in, I completely forgot about it, but I have a feeling of way too much caffeine right now. The one thing you'll find is that you can't get your heart rate low or lower between sets. It's just constantly pepped up. So you're more out of breath. You're not getting enough oxygen to your blood, not getting enough blood to your muscles. So don't have too much caffeine next time. Whew. Feel shaky. Hammered. A fucking heart rate. Oh. Right, guys, that is a session done. Really, really starting to feel that TRT kick in now. I don't feel it physically. Visually is the right word. I still feel pretty swollen, still feel pretty pumped, I still feel pretty good and full, which is probably down to the food that I'm eating. Still eating quite a lot of food, still eating around 4,600 calories, which is a 1,000 calorie drop from a couple of weeks ago, because we're just at a maintenance phase, whereas before, when I was on my blast, the goal here was just to push body weight up and push things higher and higher and higher. I'm now very much at a maintenance phase, where I'm just trying to hold it. I'm just trying to hold that tissue I built, which is going to happen through hard training, which is going to happen through hard work and eating enough food. But we're not trying to bring that body weight up, which is why we can bring it down, and it's so easy to get in. I think we'll do a full day of eating next week, just to try and show you guys how easy it is to get in 4,600 calories. One other thing is we will be taking a break on the channel very soon. We'll probably do a three, four week break maybe, as we just look to take a little bit of a break, a little bit of a recharge. 2 minutes. Got some boys staying at my house, so Bob. The car forward. Go take a little bit of a break, and then we're going to bring you the new series. The new prep series is here. So, you know, we're going to be filming bits and bobs over the March period. Today is like the 23rd of February, I think. So, maybe two or three videos left, maybe including this one. We'll take a little bit of a break. We're going to be filming the build up. I can't wait. So, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. We've got big things coming this year. Peace, everybody. Bye-bye.